गेट रेडी, 10 सेकेंड्स, 5 सेकेंड्स, स्टार्ट। मिस्टर डेप्यूटी स्पीकर सर, दिस शॉर्ट बिल सीकिंग टू मेक सर्टेन अमेंडमेंट्स टू द इंडियन एक्ट विद ए व्यू टू ग्रांटिंग प्रोटेक्शन टू द पावर एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ट्रांसफार्मर्स इंडस्ट्री and to continue or discontinue protection to certain other industries seems to suggest that it is not very much other than routine business. Sir, it is true that government come forward with amendments to the Tariff Act now and then and try to claim that they have come here to give protection to certain national industries. Sir, we all urge that the paramount necessity of our country is industrialization, and therefore any government action which might seek to improve the process of industrialization to our country is commendable. But as some of the speakers have already said, when government have brought forward this bill, they should have given a report as to the action they have taken for the development of these particular industries. You know, sir, and I want to emphasize it, that by mere continuation of the protective duty for all time to come, it is not possible to industrialize our country. We have to go to the basic needs of the industry. Sir, as the honorable friend who spoke first on this bill said, government promised that they were going to appoint a committee to go into the entire cost structure and see whether there was any possibility of the further development and further utilization of the productive power of this particular industry. Therefore, I feel when the government have come forward with such an amendment, they should give us a comprehensive report as to what actions they have taken and whether they actually appointed a committee to look into all these problems. Sir, the first point has been already discussed by some of the friends here about the power and distribution transformers industry. It is absolutely necessary for us to see that we have more electric power. Therefore, the development of a power and distribution transformers industry for the manufacture of distribution transformers is absolutely necessary. Here, some allegations were made, but we have got to see that the type of transformers that we manufacture here must be given to the people of India at the price which they can afford. Of course, for something more in certain categories of industries, it may be necessary for us to pay more for the foreign products. But we must also see that these industries must be developed properly and they must not take advantage of the protective duties or the national feeling of the consumers of our country. Therefore, sir, I feel that some attempts have to be made to see whether the transformers that are produced here are having a good market or not. All these factors must be taken into consideration before Parliament bring forward an amendment to protect a particular industry. Mere protection is not enough. They must see that the industry develops, and to that end, steps must be taken. Then another thing which is sought to be protected is body panels, including stops and sides for cars. This bill seeks to legalize the notification made by the Commerce Ministry to this effect. Sir, in moving this amending bill, the Honorable Minister said that he hoped that because of this protection, cars here would sell cheaper than foreign cars imported here. We know that in comparison, after taking into account the duties the foreign cars have to pay, the cars assembled here are cheaper. But that is not enough. It is nearly 4 or 5 years since this industry has been established, and we have to see to what extent it has been able to satisfy the needs and requirements of the consumers of the country at large. Sir, we saw reports about a year or so back that the Hindustan Motors factory wanted to close down because its production had no market. Since then, the government have taken some steps to protect the Indian manufacturers against foreign competition. But I feel, sir, that their policy should be so guided that in the case of those articles which can be produced or for which substitutes can be produced, an attempt should be made and direction should be given to the manufacturers to go in for them. Otherwise, it will mean necessary protection to industries which will mount up the cost for the consumer. Therefore, I hope government will consider all these aspects and put a limit up to which protection is to be given. We know about the sugar industry. I do not want to go into detail. The sugar industry has been protected for more than 20 years, and yet we do not know whether it can stand on its own legs. Sir, I find that the policy of imperial preference is still being continued. I wish I am not misunderstood that I am against giving protection to the industries. What I want to stress again and again is that any protection by government should necessarily be need-based and purpose-oriented.